What is going on there, Reject Nation? We just got out of the Eternals premiere. Gotta meet a whole bunch of people that we've never met before, and it was really exciting times. Social media embargo is the only thing that has lifted for this movie, so can't go into specifics. We gotta ride that nice little wiggle room where we can give our thoughts without veering too much into, we have full-on done a movie review.
We gotta make book this.
It's like, what will we say on Twitter in an extended Twitter that thought process, right?
Let's get specific in the vaguest way possible.
Exactly. So we'll just touch on some highlight, like bullet points here for you guys. And this is going to be an interesting one because I've only heard some of John's opinion, but here's what I can tell you. We have different opinions.
We do.
So John, why don't you go first?
Yeah. I'll
to give the guys an idea of the difference of opinions. Yeah.
I mean, this is going to take a while to really sink into my mind and to chew on, but just as a first viewing, I actually really enjoyed this movie. It gave me kind of a flavor that I have often been hoping to see achieved when they talk about, no, we're getting a little more serious and we're going to ask some bigger questions. I thought they actually kind of started to get to that point after a while. And yeah, I think this is one of their most beautifully hewn movies, just in terms of the locations, the costumes, the realization of the scope that they're going for being so astronomically right. huge. I think it does reach those heights. And yeah, the ensemble really felt like an ensemble. And at the start of it, you're not necessarily spending all your time with everybody. But by the end of it, I was like, yeah, I believe this is a family. There are certain members that stood out that I liked especially much as compared to others. Yeah, as a big epic that's seeking to kind of mix some different tones into the MCU. I don't know if I would call this like an out-and-out masterpiece right away, but I think it was a really sort of beautifully hewn movie. What do you think?
I thought it was okay. Now, before I go into anything, I'm still processing what I saw, so I could have a very different opinion a few days from now, but here's what I'm feeling right now. I really felt emotionally detached for a majority of the movie. I found it more of an interesting observation piece. Like, it's a lot to digest. It's a dense movie. Like, a lot of people are talking about the cinematography just being excellent. While I can see why some people love it, I personally wasn't as enamored by it as it seems like everyone else's opinion has sort of been with the film. But I do love the realization of the Celestials, like the scale, the scope of them. That's one of my favorite elements to it. What I will say, though, is that it felt a little bit hollow to me, my overall emotional experience with the film. I wasn't in love with it. I would find myself getting checked out by, wow, I've been here for a while and I really haven't felt much when and all I've done is pretty much watch cast members from the Eternals interact with each other. It's an interesting choice to take these cosmic-like characters and put them in rather isolated, almost borderline bland locations for a lot of the movie and just watch them talk to each other about like human population and major threats, but never get a sense of humanity or really their connection to humanity. I was a little bit emotionally detached. I do think that the cast, though, is still really good. I think Kumail Nanjiani is one of the highlights. He brings a lot of levity to the role of Kingo. Gilgamesh was probably my favorite character. I thought Makari was wonderful. Phastos was also great. I think everyone does a really good job. I did think Angelina Jolie was, it's weird to say she's underused because she's not really underused. But
I
you
they
still
would have written more for her.
Really didn't need a famous person for that role, especially when other characters who are nowhere near as famous as Angelina Jolie are significantly more interesting than her. And I will say the Deviants, way better than I thought they would be. I have to give credit where credit's due. The Deviants were way better than I thought they would be. When it comes to Richard Madden and Cersei, they really show a lot of it in the trailer that there's a romance between them. And that was a part of it too, where I was like, feel nothing. I feel nothing here. But, you know, like every cast member is good. Everything on a techno sale was awesome. It's just, admittedly, I found it to be a little bit of a hollow, detached experience and more of like a cool observational piece.
Mm-hmm. I think Perry Nemiroff walked out of the theater and said, that was a great book. And
Philip Molina said that to me.
Yeah,
it's a great
maybe
book.
Maybe it was him. Yeah. I think that's kind of going to be a line for people with this movie is that, yeah, it is kind of dense in terms of there are a lot of conversations and there's a lot of discussing of the greater scheme of all things and the Eternals' place and everything and humanity's place and everything. And it does at times feel a bit more like a play than it does feel like a big, you know, world-trotting movie necessarily.
To give Chloe Zhao credit on that, I would say that what makes that interesting is they managed to take these godlike beings and make them feel very human, but yet it also kind of undercuts. I never really found it intense or gripping, or I was just kind of like, yeah, I'm just watching stuff happen and occasionally laughing, finding a couple of cool moments cool. I can't tell if it was the theater or the actual movie, but there were action scenes that were just so, some of the action was great. And some of the action, I had such a hard time telling what was going on because it was so darkly lit. But I don't know if that was the theater or the actual movie. I have a feeling I'm going to be in the minority here. I'm seeing a lot of people at this screening alone who really... I'm seeing mixed... I'm seeing a lot of mixed opinions. Yeah. Just at this one screening alone. Like, Shang-Chi was like... Everyone was like... but this one, I'm seeing people who love it, didn't like it at all. And people were like, eh. And I'm kind of there. I'm kind of like... Yeah, I appreciate the intention a lot, and I appreciated what I was looking at, but I just wasn't wrapped up in it, and I was like, all right.
See, for me, I think what held it all together for me is that the dramatic weight registered and kind of kept picking up credence, because I wasn't necessarily, like, on the edge of my seat with this movie, and I wasn't necessarily like, oh my god, are they gonna fail? But at the same time, I did kind of get swept up in the drama of it all, which I will give them, and I also appreciated that the least out of... Even, I really liked a lot of Shang-Chi, and I think Shang-Chi is one of their most beautifully, you know, realized movies, but that one had a certain element to me where it felt like, oh, there's a Marvel movie jockeying for position against this other more beautiful, more out there movie, and this movie didn't have much of that at all for me. I didn't ever feel like there was a point where they were like, can we cram another action scene in here, or can we kind of like, you know, add a big CGI set piece or something? Like, the
true
use of effects and the scale and everything melded together really naturally for me.
And I'm glad it did. I think a technical achievement, yes, but as an emotional storytelling experience, I was kind of like left whatever. That was just my opinion, though.
There are a couple of post-credit scenes in this movie that you should not miss.
I found a lot more people talking about the mid and post-credit scenes than they were talking about the actual movie itself. There's a mid-credit and post-credit scene, both of which there'll be plenty of people excited about, and a lot of people will pretend to be excited about it and really having no idea what's happening in them.
I can barely hear one of them because people were screaming.
Those are my favorite post-credit scenes.
Everyone was screaming with excitement, so that's a good sign.
Those are my favorite post-credit scenes. People are like, what? And then you walk out and everyone's like, what happened in that post-credit? I don't understand. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for being here. John, since you were the more positive one today, close us out.
Guys, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and hey, check us out on the next Marvel movie review where we will collect a check from Kevin Feige himself.
Don't worry, I'm still a shill. Still a shill.
Shouts
all the way.
Shouts out to the Cosmic Wonder, Mama's Geeky off screen. Be well.